We would like to extend a very warm welcome to each one of you at the NICE Global Conclave from the labs of the beautiful Himalayas where the Nepal Institute for International Cooperation and Engagement is located. The think tank was established in the month of February in the year 2016. It undertakes independent research in the field of international relations, foreign policy, security studies, and development. NICE has four research centers: China Studies, Neighborhood Studies, Non-Traditional Security Studies, and Security and Strategic Studies. The Institute focuses on 8 research topics: climate change and energy, global governance, sustainable development and smart cities, refugee and migration, China's Belt and Road Initiative, border and transboundary water politics, Indo-Pacific affairs, disaster management, and international economy and development. Previously, NICE has had the opportunity to host distinguished speakers from all around the globe.
It was a great pleasure inviting me to speak here at NICE.
It's a real pleasure to be able to speak with all of you.
Well, thank you anyway, and I certainly admire the work that you're doing.
I'm very happy to be with you all.
NICE Global Conclave is the flagship event of the Nepal Institute for International Cooperation and Engagement Nepal. The theme of the 3-day conference is Connecting Nepal to the World by bringing leaders, diplomats, business leaders, and scholars from all around the globe. The objective of the conclave is to introduce Nepal to the world and at the same time update the Nepalese policymakers and experts about the fast-changing geopolitics, which will help Nepal reshape its foreign policy to achieve its national goal. This is the 20th session of the conference, and to chair and moderate this session, it's a real pleasure to have with us Dr. Pramod Jaiswal. Dr. Pramod Jaiswal is the Research Director at the Nepal Institute for International Cooperation and Engagement. He is a Visiting Fellow at the Sandia National Laboratories, New Mexico, and a Senior Fellow at the Institute of Peace and Conflict Studies, New Delhi. Dr. Jaiswal has been a regular and visiting faculty at different universities of Nepal and China. Without any further ado, sir, I'd like to request you to take the session forward.
Dr. Bijay Chauthaiwale and distinguished participants, namaste and good afternoon. Welcome to the 20th session of NICE Global Conclave. We're having a very special session on Nepal-India relations with Dr. Bijay Chauthaiwale, in charge, Department of Foreign Affairs, Bharatiya Janata Party. Dr. Bijay Chauthaiwale, we are really privileged to have you with us at NICE. We are really grateful and honored for providing us your valuable time. Dr. Bijay Chauthaiwale needs no introduction. However, let me briefly introduce Dr. Chauthaiwale. Dr. Bijay Chauthaiwale is in charge, Department of Foreign Affairs, Bharatiya Janata Party, since November 2014. He is a PhD in microbiology from University of Pune, India, with 4 years of experience in a postdoctoral fellow as a postdoctoral fellow at National Institute of Health, United States. In 2011, he participated in 2014 Lok Sabha election campaign by taking sabbatical from his professional work. He was stationed in the BJP headquarters in New Delhi for campaign coordination. He is a member of Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh since his childhood. He has also served on the board of studies of Indian universities. He is co-editor of 2 books entitled Hindutva in Present Context, which was published in 2019, and The Modi Doctrine, New Paradigms in India's Foreign Policy, published in August 2016, released by Minister of External Affairs, Sushma Swaraj. He is a coordinating Indian diaspora worldwide through Overseas Friends of BJP, which has chapter in more than 40 countries around the world. He's also serving as a member of different committees, boards, and advisory groups. He has authored peer-reviewed scientific papers in international journals and is co-inventor of several global patents. He's also a regular columnist on various national and international issues. His columns are published in the Asian Age, Indian Express, The Print, The Quint, and many other medias. The program is streaming live on Facebook, and we would like to request all our participants to share the video link on their social media so that maximum can benefit from this discussion. Please drop your question in the Zoom chat or on the Facebook Live. Dr. Chauthaywale, we would like to request you to make a presentation in 20, 25, or maybe 30 minutes, sir. Thank you.
Dear Dr. Pramod Jaiswal, Research Director of NICE, and all the attendees of this prestigious conclave. It is indeed great pleasure for me to join here, and I am really thankful for Dr. Jaiswal to invite me in this prestigious conclave. Today, I am going to address one quite a sensitive, a topic of great interest to everyone in the region, and that is India-Nepal relations. Especially in the current political atmosphere in Nepal, I know that my comments will be listened very carefully, and also might be people will try to make some assessment about it. But I will try to make my comments very simple and straightforward. Friends, India and Nepal are tied up with each other in many ways. And maybe no other country on this planet would have such a long-lasting and complex relationship. We are tied up by our geography, by our culture, by our heritage, by our civilization, by our common ancestry, and also by many values, social customs, and relations. We follow common religious paths and also respect common heroes in the histories and Puranas. In the modern world, two sovereign countries, Nepal and India, have developed their relations based on equitable partnership and also respect for each country. In this context, there is very natural that people would be very curious on how a geographically much bigger country like India look towards Nepal. And then there are many questions and apprehensions in the people of Nepal, some of which are quite natural. Any country would have that if they have any big neighbor around themselves. But I would like to assure you that India looks at Nepal as a sovereign country with a great respect for its tradition, for its democratic system, and also for its people. And we would be as friendly as any good friends would like to be. Of course, two friends would agree on certain issues and may not agree on certain issues, but it should not impact our overall relations. And that is precisely what India would like to work with Nepal. We have three levels of relations, broadly speaking. One is, of course, government to government relations. At second level, we have people-to-people relations. And third is, of course, our cultural relations. The cultural relations and civilizational relations are easy to deal with and to address. We have a vast common boundary, which is not restricted for the people's movement, And therefore, for centuries, people from both the sides keep coming to each other's side and even settle. There are close to 40 lakhs, 4 million people of Nepal origin settled in India, and by some estimate, the number might be much more. They are contributing significantly in the Indian economy, and similarly, there are several thousands of people from India are working and settled in Nepal, and I am sure they are also contributing to the economy of Nepal. Due to our common religious connections, thousands of pilgrims every year travel to each other's lands and pray to their destined gods or goddesses. And that creates another connection to both the countries. I don't need to elaborate that part very much because we all are aware of it. The second part is about the government. As you all know, that Prime Minister Modi was the first Prime Minister to visit Nepal almost after a gap of 2 decades. There was a hiatus, there was a gap, and the Nepal relations were to an extent taken for granted by India. But Prime Minister Modi has taken a renewed effort to re-establish these relations at every level. His famous speech at Nepali Parliament in 2015 was seen and viewed as one of the most friendly speeches Nepal might have ever heard from a foreign leader. When he traveled again second time, he also visited Janakpur and Mukteshwar, and again touching upon the common civilizational ancestry and religious faiths and strengthening them. We have signed several agreements and accords, some of which are implemented, some of which are not implemented to the extent possible for various reasons. But the intention is always very clear that India is looking forward for a very strong partnership with Nepal. The third level of relations is a political relations between the political parties of Nepal and political parties of India. While in past there used to be some structured dialogue between political parties of India with that of in Nepal, in the recent past, that process has been somehow not functional. During my recent visit to Nepal, I appealed to all the political leaders whom I have met, and they belong to wide spectrum of politics in Nepal, that we need to strengthen this process. And the largest party and the ruling party of India, Bharatiya Janata Party, we are very keen to initiate this dialogue. Unfortunately, because of Corona, we couldn't continue that process. But as soon as the situation improves, BJP as a political party will be very keen to have exchanges of political leaders with Nepali politicians from various spectrum. I, as a in charge of Foreign Affairs Department of BJP, I firmly believe that these kind of political exchanges are important part of a dialogue, and that will further strengthen the relations between two countries, help understand each other's, and also resolve several misunderstanding and misconceptions about each other. Therefore, it is in the interest of both the countries that these political dialogues should continue and should be strengthened. In Nepal, politics is always a kind of enigma and curiosity for me. I continuously meet Nepali politicians, and of course, they all are also looking for similar very good relations with India. There are, of course, small section of politics who come to India, talk something, and then go back and continue their anti-India rhetoric for their political objectives. While all this is fine as far as politics is concerned, but I simply wish that such rhetorics would not hurt the relations between two countries. India as a country has always extended its helping hand to Nepal whenever Nepal has certain critical issues or crises. May it be Corona this time, or may it be earthquake few years back. And India would continue to do it. The supply of essential medicines and vaccines during Corona is simply one of such examples. India also would like to continue to be a partner in the development and progress of Nepal by contributing to major initiatives and projects within Nepal. We firmly believe that such investment will be good not only for Nepal, but also it will strengthen India-Nepal relations. Dear friends, note that even among those in Nepal who may have political and ideological differences with our party BJP, there are many who are pragmatic and enlightened enough to work together for greater good of bilateral relations. We welcome such constructive developments and always open to them. From any side, any party, any segment of Nepal's vibrant, pluralistic and democratic politics. Under the leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, India has always extended her helping hand. India is also an active partner in Nepal's development projects. Under Prime Minister Modi, India will remain a close friend of Nepal and active partner in the development. Let me summarize my talk by saying that the people of Nepal will not find better friend and well-wisher than Prime Minister Modi. Therefore, I am pretty sure that in spite of some misunderstanding and miscommunication at few levels, overall relations between India and Nepal are strong and will remain strong. And I wish all of you a great success. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your enlightening remarks. Maybe we can take one or two questions if you have time. We are flooded with questions, so without wasting any seconds, let me move to the question. The first question is, Nepal and India enjoys close ties and their relations are unique in the world, as we enjoy open border, have socio-economic, cultural, historical, religious ties. So in this context, how important is Nepal in India's foreign policy?
It is very important because we are very close neighbors. We share a lot of natural resources, and also we share common practices. And in that respect, I think it is a very multidimensional relationship. And anything which weakens these relations actually can have negative impact on both the countries. And therefore, I think that in a very partnership and a collaborative way, we both countries need to address all these issues.
Thank you, sir. Let me move to next question. Like, as you know, India has made rapid economic transformation in the last 2-3 decades, and it's placing itself as the world's fifth economy in the world. With the high rate of India's economic rise, the aspiration of its neighbors, including Nepal, has increased. Hence, how can India and Nepal work together for economic transformation of Nepal?
I think there are 2-3 things that have happened in India, which has resulted into the rapid economic progress. There is broadly a consensus about political parties about the economic issues. And of course, there are might be some differences. For example, when there was a liberalization in India in around 1990, almost all political parties have supported it. And that has created a kind of a policy stability within India. Second part is the use of technology. And that technology not only for the people of affluence, but also for the people who are at the bottom of the pyramid. And Prime Minister Modi ji has made a significant contribution in use of technology for the betterment of people, for the transparent government, reduction in the corruption, and also making technology accessible to the common man. These are some of the lessons which I think Nepal can emulate, and some of the technologies that can be adopted even in Nepal for the very rapid economic progress, which I am sure Nepal is capable of. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Let me move to the third question. At the time when India and Nepal is struggling with COVID-19, how can India help Nepal in vaccinating the Nepali people through India's neighborhood first policy?
India has given support during the pandemic, not only to Nepal, not only to the neighboring countries, but also close to 70 countries in the world have received medicines, PPE kits, masks, etc. from India. Even during pandemic, India has enhanced its capabilities and capacities for the manufacturing of these essential items in a big way. For example, when the pandemic started, India couldn't produce even 100,000 PPE kits. But now India is not only able to produce PPE kits which are sufficient for Indian healthcare providers and frontline warriors, but also India is exporting it. Same thing is about vaccines. Now India has supplied vaccine to several countries, in many countries as a grant in aid, and in many countries through the bilateral government contracts and also private contracts. I know that India has also supplied the Covishield vaccine to Nepal. Right now, I am also aware that there is a discussion going on about additional supplies of vaccine to Nepal. I am sure that the government of India is considering it very carefully. And as soon as such supplies are available, Nepal and neighboring countries will be of the priority for India.
Thank you, sir. We are flooded with questions. I think there are more than 80 or 90 questions, but due to lack of time, let me put the last question. Like Prime Minister Modi's official visit to Nepal was almost after two decades, and there was not a single visit by UPA's Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh, while Prime Minister Modi made four official visits to Nepal in 4 years. It looks Nepal is very special to BJP government. So what is your comment on it?
I fully agree with you. And in my speech also, I have made such a remark that Nepal was something which was not given due attention during UPA regime. And in the critical time when there were a lot of changes taking place in Nepal. But for Prime Minister Modi, Nepal was, and even today it is, a top priority country, and we would do whatever is required and whatever is possible from our side to strengthen the partnership. So it is not a surprise that Prime Minister Modi invited head of the government from the SAARC countries, including that of Nepal, for his swearing-in ceremony in 2014, and again took first trips to nearby countries in the neighborhood, including Nepal, in the first year of his prime ministership. It shows that he gives great importance to relations between India and Nepal. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Dr. Bijay Chowthiwale, here we come to the end of the discussion. And we'd like to thank you once again for your valuable time. We immensely benefited from the discussion, and I'm sure our audience also benefited from it. We'd be glad to host you again in future, in real, in Kathmandu. So hope to see you soon, sir. Thank you so much and have a nice day.
Namaskar to everyone and wish you all the best. Thank you.
Distinguished Chair, speakers, ladies and gentlemen, as we have come to the end of this session, we would like to express our sincere gratitude and thanks to the Chair for agreeing to chair and moderate the session today. Our sincere thanks also goes to all the speakers for being a part of the event and delivering such comprehensive and convincing presentations. We would like to acknowledge our gratitude to our friends from the diplomatic community, experts, academia, media, and different organizations. Finally, we must also mention our deep sense of appreciation for the audience who participated in the webinar and those who are watching us live. Thank you for your valuable time and attention and for making this session productive with your questions. Once again, we are truly honored to have you all with us today. Please do join us in the next session. Thank you so much.